Hey guys. Here we go again. Gotta start all over. I haven't posted for a while because I just haven't felt up to it. I've not been feeling that great. Now, I never feel great when my estrogen levels are low. Anyways, I never feel great on my period. And I've had migraines for about a week and a half now. So every day, just very mild, horrible headaches. And I've had to take lots of medications every single day for the last week and a half. And by the time I get to this point, like, I'm so worn down from the headaches every day that I literally just have no, not a single ounce of positivity in me. And I know that once my estrogen levels come back up, I'll start feeling better, but it's also obviously compounded by the total and complete defeat that I felt last month. I remember when I was in, after I had my surgery, there was a lady sitting next to me, and she had just done her second cycle, and she said to me, you know, it does get easier as you keep going. And she did her second cycle because when she did her first cycle, they could only get eggs from one side, and they only got one. They tried to get to the other side, they couldn't get there, there was too much scar tissue or something in the way, or something was going on. So they could only get eggs from one side, and they only got one, and it died overnight. So I mean, imagine that, like nothing. You go through all that and nothing. So she had to go again, and then when I saw her that day, the day that I got four, she had gotten five. So she was pretty excited, and she was sitting there, and I was way more drowsy than her because they'd given me more medications, but she was like, oh, it gets better, honey, with the second cycle. You just get used to it. So I can understand what she's saying in the sense that I've started now. I started yesterday, and I'm just robotic with it. Like, I feel nothing. Like, I'm not excited. I'm not scared. I'm not disappointed anymore. I'm just doing it. There's my needle. So I just have to just give myself the injection and just do it. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I have to count to 10. Now that one didn't bleed. Yesterday it bled a lot for some reason. And then I put it back into my little container. So yeah, I don't know if it's a good thing or not, but I feel nothing. So I'm just gonna go through the steps. I'm not gonna expect anything to come out of this cycle, and I'm just gonna do it just because I have to. And that's it. And that's the reality. And it is what it is. So, it's nice to feel a bit more numb because I'm going through the motions and yeah, I'm just gonna move on with my life, so. Yeah. Definitely feels very different from last month, and unfortunately this could be my reality for a while. So I guess that's kind of like when people are diabetics, they really struggle with the diagnosis, and then after a while you just have acceptance and you just do what you have to do, and you just gotta tell your feelings to shut up because they lie to you. That's what Dani Johnson says. She says, tell your feelings to shut up because feelings and thoughts are all lies. We accept them as truth. Like, we have this thought, like, you're stupid or you're a failure or whatever. Whatever these negative thoughts that we have in our life, we take these thoughts as ultimate truth. And the reality is thoughts are stupid. And because they're coming in from our own head, we think that we take them as truth. And that's not the reality. So I've just been telling my thoughts to shut up. And I've just been trying to ignore them because I can see how people get really carried away when you listen to your own internal dialogue. And that's not something that I usually have to deal with because I'm very easily distracted. And, you know, I can be really sad and then be like, oh my gosh, look at the beautiful sunset. And I haven't been that way for a while, which is really sad. But I just have to be a bit more calculated, a bit more cold, a bit more, you know, apply psychological therapy and just be like, shut up thoughts, shut up, I'm moving on with my day. I'm not happy, but I'm trying to not be sad. that's it. Anyways, this is kind of depressing, but yeah. So I do just this one injection for a few days, and then I have to start the two. And they started me, you know, last time I started on 87, because it was my very first cycle, 87 units. And then this time, because I've already tried the 87 and they put me up to 125 because I wasn't responding, I'm starting on 125. So I'm desperately hoping that this time it won't take me 3 weeks to get there, because I'm starting on the higher dose. So fingers crossed, who knows? Like they said, I'm really unusual and they don't know why I do what I do. Yeah, okay. I will talk to you guys later.